Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Well, what I'm going to testify is not my testimony, but I believe it's my sister's testimony who lives in Kuwait. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
A few weeks back, she suddenly fell ill, and when she was taken to the hospital, they found out that she had an attack, a heart attack. At that time, the hospital in Kuwait was not equipped to have a cardiologist, but the doctors on duty managed to resuscitate her, and they had to give her a life-saving injection. The following 3 days, 4 days, she was kept in ICU until they were to perform a procedure that's called the angiogram. We only heard about her condition a day after she had the attack. And as natural, my first instinct was, I was worried, very worried. But then, and had not spoken to her for 2 days, 3 days, while she was in the ICU, because obviously mobile phones are not allowed in the unit. It's only when they transferred her to a normal room in the hospital that I managed to talk to her. And most of my messages to her was relayed through my brother-in-law. And I was continuously sending her Bible messages, 5-6 messages during the day, and telling my brother-in-law to tell her to read out the message to her. The day I spoke to her, I gave her this passage, which is a favorite in my family, shared by Brother Johnson. I am the body of Christ, and Satan, you have no power over me. And when I spoke to her, she burst out crying. She's saying, Ivan, I'm very worried. I said, so are we, but now, what I'm telling you, I want you to recite this particular verse as many times as you can remember. And believe in your heart that you have Jesus by your side. You have Jesus in you. The Bible teaches us that God has set Himself in us. We are His temple. She began to recite this verse continuously. And as I was sharing Bible passages with her, she began to develop on the line that I'd given. She began to add on saying that, Jesus, you are the Savior of my soul. Jesus, I feel your presence in me. And I believe you have already healed me. And I was so amazed and happy when she told me, she's saying, Ivan, this is what I'm saying. But I told her, I said, I never told you to say that. She's saying, no, I read one of the passages that you, Bible verses that you sent me, and I'm just saying that. I said, praise the Lord, I'm so happy that you have said that, because that is what it is. Once you have believed with faith that Jesus has healed you, you have been healed. The procedure to get an angiogram in Kuwait is very difficult for an expat, so we really do not know when she was going to be taken for an angiogram. All of a sudden, on Wednesday, my brother-in-law called me, he said, I'm here in the hospital, they're taking Margaret in for the angiogram. Say a prayer for her. So, I said, can I talk to her? He said, okay, quickly, and he passed the phone to her, and I said, Jesus is with you all the way, Margaret. You do not have to be worried. And she was all smiling, you know. Later in the afternoon, my brother sent me a message, all is okay, praise the Lord. You know, so. From medical point of view, many of us may not understand as to what happened. The doctors do not know how they could not find a single block. When they did the angiogram, they could not find a single block. The very fact that they had to use this life-saving injection, which is around 800 kd, I don't know how it converts into rupees, but it's quite a lot of money. The very fact that they had to use that injection was because she had a life-threatening situation. When I spoke to her, I said, Margaret, how do you feel? She said, I feel I'm a bit tired, but just as the procedure was going on, I could feel a tingling sensation in my body. And she's saying, as I was going in to the operation theater, I was laughing, but the moment they put me on the table, I began to cry. I said, that's okay. We're all human at the end of the day, and we do feel frightened. But she's saying, at that moment, I quickly remembered what he told me. I am the body of Christ. Christ is in me. So if Christ is in me, I am strong. And she's saying, with that strength, I just said, Lord, it's not the doctor who's doing the procedure. You are. And I believe that all those stents and everything that they have prepared to go ahead with an angioplasty will not be necessary.
Praise the Lord.
And it was not. Praise the Lord.